The church is for perfect people, period. Praise the Lord, everyone. My name is Brother Mario. Welcome back to the channel. And if you're brand new, welcome. The purpose of this channel is I'm here to show you that we are real apostolics, real problems with real solutions, all solved in a divine way. In today's video, I really want to address something that's been near and dear to my heart, something that I've been thinking of for a while. Now, if you've clicked on this video, obviously the title is perplexing, that someone is actually going to sit here and admit that the church is in fact for perfect people. And I guess you're right. I mean, I guess no one in the church has problems. I guess everyone in the church is doing well financially. I guess everyone in the church has dealt with their past. I guess no diseases run in the church. So yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, the church is in fact for perfect people. The problem with that is everything I just said was factually incorrect times 1,000. The church is for the broken. The church is for those who need healing. The church is for those whose lives are destroyed. Think of it like this. A perfect God came down to sacrifice himself on a cross so you and I may be saved and be taken up out of this broken world, which is only getting worse, so we could spend paradise with him. But he only wanted perfect people. No. God already knew that we were imperfect, but just like the great Apostle Paul says, no one knows how high, how far, how deep is God's love for his people. And you might be watching this because you've probably been hurt by the church. And from the church, I sincerely apologize whoever hurt you, but we are an imperfect people. We all make mistakes. Just because we go to church does not mean our life is in order, does not mean problems vanish when you start following Jesus. As a matter of fact, what happens is we really make the enemy angry. But we don't have to be scared of the enemy. He may throw pebbles at us, but we've got a fortress around us, and his name is Jesus. He is our refuge. He is our strength. He is our fortitude. He is our warrior that fights for us. He is going to make sure that you make it to the very end. All you've got to do is trust in his plan. And part of that plan is going to church. You have to realize that the church is made up of a bunch of hypocrites. We're made up of a bunch of people who sin daily. We're made up of a bunch of people that don't have our lives together. We're made up of a church that divorces happen. We're made up of a church where we tell white lies, and that's just part of it. If we were all perfect, well, I guess we wouldn't need God, you know? Because we're already perfect the way we are, right? Wrong. We are so imperfect. We are so ready to admit to ourselves that we are imperfect, that we see the one who is perfect, and we want to progressively become like him. There's a lot of misconceptions about the church. And to be honest with you, if I really told you that you were sick and that you're not sick enough to go to the hospital, you would call me crazy. But the thing is about a hospital, when it comes to healing people, it doesn't matter the degree that you're hurting or the sickness that you are, they will help you at all times. If you have a cough all the way to stage 4 cancer, they will help you if you come. The same with the church. It does not matter what stage you are in your life. If you believe you are spiritually fine or you are spiritually about to have a meltdown, the church is always there to help you. And so we ask ourselves, well, what's the purpose of the church? Maybe no one's ever told you. Maybe you've literally never heard anyone tell you what is the purpose of the church. Well, David said it like this, it's the gateway to heaven. We have to understand that the church was created for our good. It was created for our benefit. God wanted to come and heal. He wanted to find the lost. Jesus said it, that I did not come for those who are healed. I came for those who are broken. I did not come to find those who are found. I come to find those who are lost. And you right there watching this are one of those too. You're either lost or you're broken. And the only one that can find you or the only one that can heal you, his name is Jesus Christ. And he's the reason why we go there. We go there because we want to seek his presence. We want to hear his counsel. We know Jesus Christ to be the great counselor. Imagine going to a therapist that knew all your problems and also gave you all the solutions at the same time. Imagine going to a doctor who knew all your symptoms and prescribed you all the right medications for you to become better. That's what Jesus is, and he created a place for us to go. He created the church. Now, although the church is not the physical building, the church is when all his believers come together as one body. Let me ask you this, you right there, have you ever created something beautiful? Isn't it amazing when your heart, your mind, your soul, your hands and your feet all come together for one purpose and you create? Isn't the creation you've made beautiful? Don't you appreciate it? Well, that's how God looks on us. He created us, and he knows that if we would just all come together and worship him, if we would all come together and seek his counsel, he'll give us everything that we need. See, at the end of the day, the church that I go to, we're not all perfect. As a matter of fact, we all have our days, myself included, but we move forward. Because at the end of the day, I'm not there for my pastor. I'm not there for the leader of the ministers. I'm not there for the music ministry. At the end of the day, I'm going there to seek God. And he has brought me there specifically for a purpose to do his will. But that's between me and God. It's really not there to please men or please anyone else. If we would just have the attitude, if we would just realize how imperfect we are, we would realize that healing and restoration is all around the corner, but it takes a special type of person. To be honest with you, Jesus said it's better to be a fool than to be wise, because a fool will know to follow Jesus, and a wise person, well, they think they've got it all together and they think they know it all, not realizing that they're the fool and the fool really is the wise. So I really don't know who this video was for. Really spoke off the top, and probably a lot of this is not gonna make sense when I go back to editing, but I know this video was for somebody. Look, I invite you right now, if you're imperfect, welcome to the Imperfect Club. I'm right there with you too, brother. I'm right there with you, sister. I can't stand being perfect because I don't even know what that would look like, but I know the one who is perfect, and he looks pretty good, and he's working something in my life. And to be honest with you, me making these videos don't get me any brownie points, doesn't get me any closer to heaven. I do it because I enjoy this, and that's all I do this for. And so, man, church is for perfect people. Crazy. It's never been for perfect people. Hope you all enjoyed this content here. If you like it, I appreciate if you give me a like on this video, as it does help the algorithm. And just understand that we are real apostolics, real problems with real solutions, all solved in divine way. My name is Brother Mario. Be blessed. Be less stressed. Peace.